get all the stuff. I want you to pull that tray out, get the stuff out of there, and get the water hose and spray it off, clean it out. And then I think you can get the broom and sweep up, get that wood out of here and sweep up in here. Okay. Are getting bigger, and they're about ready to be out just in the grass. So what I've got to do is I'm going to work on making another one of these, but it's going to have a door and it's going to be butted up against the old chicken pen down there on this side. Part we're going to be building the new chicken coop. This will house the chickies for the time being while they continue to get bigger and let the older chickens acclimate to them. The second half will be building yet another one of these, except for it won't have a tarp over it and it'll have chicken wire around it, and it'll just be extra space for them to get out on the grass and dig around and move around while they're in the pen. So we will be getting rid of the old chicken coop. I might use those for the ducks. We haven't really decided what we're going to do with those with them yet, how we're going to have them set up. Right now they're doing good with the chickens, so I don't know if we'll keep them all together or what. So, but they're still small. We still got to keep them warm with a lamp for now. And but yeah, so today's project is not only to build one of these two, but we're finally going to put a gate. So the other day I set the post, I dug the hole, put the concrete in, so it's nice and sturdy. So it'll be a gate on this side and then the normal gate on the inside. But yeah, so let's get to it. Alright, if you've got T-posts that you need to move, or you're moving often, like you change your mind, or you do different random stuff, like I do, decide to move some stuff around. This thing right here is a T-post puller. One of the greatest things ever. Super simple. And I know, really that T-post wasn't in the ground much. It's probably about a foot or so, but I couldn't pull it up with my hands even when I was wiggling it. So those T-post pullers definitely come in handy when it comes to pulling T-posts. So, definitely recommend and get one. Luckily, my dad, when I was a kid, we grew up putting fence up for our goats, and he had one. Same, so you can't beat borrowing stuff from your parents. You can see I got the frame put up. It's a little bit more difficult than say the other one because one of those is a little bent, so I got a little frustrated, so I sat down for a minute and to cool off. I was getting pretty heated. It was aggravating me. But so I got the cage on. I was gonna go ahead and put the tarp on, and then I realized the tarp I got was too small. So we just ran to the store and grabbed another tarp. So what I'm gonna do actually, I was thinking about it, was I'm actually gonna build the door frames first. I'm not sure how I'm going to cover it. On the outside, on the other side of it, I'm going to be using like fence slats to make it like a wall, a good sturdy wall. But because that inside piece is gonna butt up against the old fence, I might just use the, I've got some more of this black wind stop. I might use that on the inside because most of the wind is going to come from, you know, most of our wind comes from the lake side this way. So that's why I'm putting the coop on this side, like I should have done over here. But the coop on this side, give them good protection on this side. And then over here, it's more just a cover to kind of keep it a little more protection stuff. So also I'm gonna wait to put the tarp on till I get the frame built, because once I build the frame and I scoot it up against there, the tarp's a little bit bigger, so I might kind of form the tarp onto the fencing itself too, kind of help with a little rain block also, so it doesn't drip inside of it and get all wet inside. So step by step, right now I'm gonna work on building framing out like the doors, and then I'll go from there the next step. Here's where we are so far. We've got right here where the door is going to be framed up. Right here where the door is, got it framed up. We've got the tarp put on it and kind of secured it to the old pin. So what we'll do is on the inside of this pin is I'll cut a hole where they can come in and out from. And then, so right now I'm putting, but I got this pipe insulation. I don't know if you can really see it. So I got pipe insulation on here to help cover up any sharp edges. It's like right here. It's not really looking like what I had hoped, but it should work. It's gonna be pretty good. So I'm not too disappointed with it. Once it's finished, be a lot better, a lot more room for sure, definitely. So I'll have to get some. I'll build some boxes for them. Either build some or see if anybody's got some on Facebook Marketplace. So kids are out here playing like crazy. Hiding. Chickens. Let's just put it in the hole and we'll see where it looks. We made some pretty good progress. We got it framed in. Already showed you. We got the door done. Not done, but we got the door on. This probably took the most time, really, just because these 2x3s, they're not the straightest. So it's the end of the day. I'm tired of working on it. So I've got to work the next 2 days. I'm off Friday. Hopefully I'll be able to finish up and do the wood slats and that'll be it for, and then I can move the little chicks into it for a little while. But yeah, so I'll catch back up with you when I'm off in a couple days and we'll finish it up. Got the wall put up. Got the door done. Got the door done. So that's pretty much it. Got a couple small things in here that we'll do. Like, I'm gonna clip off all these nails. You can see that where they came through, so I'll clip all those off that way. That way nobody gets scratched on them and don't hurt any of the chickens and stuff. But, and then on the pieces right here are these gaps. That'll allow for ventilation, but I'm also going to use some more of the windscreen to put in it. That way it'll help not be too drafty, but allow air and stuff to move. And also it'll give it a little bit more protection. And I'll put some screen, some hardware fabric on there too, just to protect. So, and then I'll tack all the tarp down. But that's pretty much it. You can see. It's a good area. You know, it's a 8x8 area. So I'll get some brooder box or some boxes for them to lay in, probably do it on both sides or something, and we'll figure out some kind of layout in here that works the best for them. And that way they can come in here and they'll be protected, have more room, and be able to lay their eggs. We can get in here a lot easier than crawling through that little door that we've been crawling through. But yeah, so that's pretty much gonna sum up this video. Like I said, I've got just like a couple small things here and there I've got to do. Door latch and tack stuff down, but yeah. So appreciate you stick around for this little project, and like I said, this is only part one. Part two will come later on once they get a little bit bigger and we can acclimate them to the older chickens, and then I will get rid of the other coop and then build another hoop house using just screen and wire, so that they'll just have more room to roam and stuff while we're not letting them out. So, yeah. Appreciate you sticking around, and we'll see you in the next one.